What's up, YouTube? This is Christopher Ramirez coming at you with another video. And look what we got going on now. And as far as computers going, one of the biggest brands they have in the game, Intel, going to the next level, which is quantum computing with their devices. And if you do not know what quantum computing is, I'm gonna go ahead and have a little real play for you guys. To go ahead and school you on what quantum computers are. So with that said, let it roll.
In the quantum realm, physics works quite differently from the predictable ways we're used to, and traditional computers just stop making sense. We are approaching a real physical barrier for our technological progress. To solve this problem, scientists are trying to use these unusual quantum properties to their advantage by building quantum computers. In normal computers, bits are the smallest units of information. Quantum computers use qubits, which can also be set to one of two values. A qubit can be any two-level quantum system, such as a spin in a magnetic field or a single photon. 0 and 1 are this system's possible states, like the photon's horizontal or vertical polarization. In the quantum world, the qubit doesn't have to be in just one of those, it can be in any proportions of both states at once. This is called superposition. But as soon as you test its value, say by sending the photon through a filter, it has to decide to be either vertically or horizontally polarized. So as long as it's unobserved, the qubit is in a superposition of probabilities for 0 and 1, and you can't predict which it will be. But the instant you measure it, it collapses into one of the definite states. Superposition is a game changer. 4 classical bits can be in one of 2 to the power of 4 different configurations at a time. That's 16 possible combinations, out of which you can use just one. 4 qubits in superposition, however, can be in all of those 16 combinations at once. This number grows exponentially with each extra qubit. 20 of them can already store a million values in parallel. A really weird and unintuitive property qubits can have is entanglement, a close connection that makes each of the qubits react to a change in the other's state instantaneously, no matter how far they are apart. This means that when measuring just one entangled qubit, you can directly deduce properties of its partners without having to look. Qubit manipulation is a mind-bender as well. A normal logic gate gets a simple set of inputs and produces one definite output. A quantum gate manipulates an input of superpositions, rotates probabilities, and produces another superposition as its output. So a quantum computer sets up some qubits, applies quantum gates to entangle them and manipulate probabilities, and finally measures the outcome, collapsing superpositions to an actual sequence of zeros and ones. What this means is that you get the entire lot of calculations that are possible with your setup all done at the same time. Ultimately, you can only measure one of the results, and it will only probably be the one you want, so you may have to double-check and try again. But by cleverly exploiting superposition and entanglement, this can be exponentially more efficient than would ever be possible on a normal computer. So while quantum computers will probably not replace our home computers, in some areas they are vastly superior. One of them is database searching. To find something in a database, a normal computer may have to test every single one of its entries. Quantum algorithms need only the square root of that time, which for large databases is a huge difference. The most famous use of quantum computers is ruining IT security. Right now, your browsing, email, and banking data is being kept secure by an encryption system in which you give everyone a public key to encode messages only you can decode. The problem is that this public key can actually be used to calculate your secret private key. Luckily, doing the necessary math on any normal computer would literally take years of trial and error. But a quantum computer with exponential speedup could do it in a breeze. Another really exciting new use is simulations. Simulations of the quantum world are very intense on resources, and even for bigger structures, such as molecules, they often lack accuracy. So why not simulate quantum physics with actual quantum physics? Quantum simulations could provide new insights on proteins that might revolutionize medicine. Right now, we don't know if quantum computers will be just a very specialized tool or a big revolution for humanity. We have no idea where the limits of technology are, and there's only one way to find out. This video is supported by the Australian Academy.
It's a great video. There's other videos, but I didn't want to, like, really drag it on. too long. But yeah, anyhow, yeah, quantum computing is really gonna start taking off next to a lot of other things that's been going on in the news. I don't know if y'all been paying attention to the Bitcoin. Bitcoin, if you ain't got your digital wallet and your cryptocurrency building up in your wallet, you're gonna be missing out on the next spikes in the Bitcoin community. And it's really interesting stuff how that works. But I'm not gonna go into detail on the Bitcoin. But you know, I definitely do want to recommend some of the computers that they have. Here's an Intel computer. I didn't even know they had these kinds of computers for $382, really, 75 cents. I'm looking at this thing, and it's got a sixth generation Intel Core i5-6260. So that, I'm loving that shit. So, you know, grab that thing. I mean, it's a steal. I'm totally for that, because I just bought a $600 computer. But this is a nice deal right here, because I have a desktop that don't even have an i5. And that's, so it's kind of like Moore's Law they talk about. If you don't know what Moore's Law is, it means that computing power doubles in speed, exponential growth in power and speed, and even shrinks in size about half as well. It goes down even more in size and doubles in speed every 18 months, a year and a half. That's Moore's Law. So yeah, look at this. You already got a piece of hardware, $382. Oh yeah, that's part of Moore's Law too. Like the price goes lower, all that shit. Look it up. Moore's Law is nice stuff. But yeah, go ahead, peep this piece of hardware out. This is a nice little piece of hardware I didn't even know existed. Just to show you, because I got this computer right here. Since the Beats days, man, I'm looking at this computer's pushing like 11 years old. I'm still stunting the operating system from 11 years ago on this computer. It's really interesting, but you know, go ahead and pick it up. Links in the description. All right, get that present for your friend or family. Peace. I'll see y'all in the next video.